In this video, I will discuss some typical sensors found in a weather station and show how to mount them for best performance. A weather station contains several different sensors to monitor current weather conditions. In this example, I will be adding 5 types of sensors to the station. These are a barometer, an anemometer, a temperature and relative humidity sensor, a pyranometer, and a tipping bucket rain gauge. The sensor models shown in this video are just examples. Campbell Scientific offers many other sensor models as well. A weather station requires a solid platform that can withstand any weather conditions. I will be using the CM106B tripod with a crossarm as a base for my weather station. I will include an enclosure with a CR1000XE data logger and a PS200 power supply. So I will also add a solar panel. It's important to note the CR1000XE will control the sensor measurements using the CR Basic program I send it. I will create this program using Shortcut, which is an application designed for easily creating data collection programs. In addition to generating the program, Shortcut will also create a wiring diagram for the complete system. Campbell Scientific offers videos that demonstrate how to use Shortcut to create a program. Refer to the Quick Start video for each specific data logger for more information. Before going to the installation site, it's best practice to test the system in a lab environment. This ensures all components are working properly together. Follow the wiring diagram to connect each sensor to the data logger and check for proper function. Once proper operation is confirmed, it's time to assemble the weather station in the field. I begin assembly with the tripod oriented so one leg points away from the equator. This will align the solar panel in an optimal position to keep the system powered. The crossarm is running east-west. The first sensor I'll be adding is the barometer. In this case, I'm adding a BaroView 10. It uses a microelectromechanical system, or MEMS, to measure the barometric pressure and sends this data to the data logger via an SDI-12 output. It is mounted inside the station enclosure, either flat or on one edge, using grommets and screws. Next, I want to measure wind speed. This is done using an anemometer. I will add the 03002 wind sentry. The wind sentry is a mechanical anemometer that uses spinning cups with a pulse output signal to determine wind speed. The wind sentry also includes a wind vane with a resistive bridge output signal to determine wind direction. These two measurements are frequently taken together for a more complete weather measurement. It's important when placing an anemometer to be aware of the immediate surroundings. Any close obstructions, like trees or buildings, will affect wind measurements, so it's important to place the tripod in an open area. The wind sentry is mounted on a vertical tube, which is then attached to the crossarm with a bracket. Depending on the bracket is held in position with U-bolts or set screws. I'll mount the wind sentry at one end of the crossarm. Next, I will install the HygroView 10, a digital SDI-12 sensor to measure air temperature and relative humidity. The HygroView 10 is installed in a radiation shield to protect the sensor from direct solar radiation to improve the measurement quality. Slide the HygroView 10 into the radiation shield until the top of the sensor is about 1/3 of the way down from the top of the shield. The bracket on the radiation shield allows it to be mounted on either a horizontal or a vertical tube. I will mount it on the mast with a U-bolt, nuts, and washers. The next sensor to install is the CS320, a digital SDI-12 pyranometer to measure solar radiation. To mount the CS320 on the tripod, I'll use a CM226 solar radiation bracket. This bracket allows me to position the CS320 at the opposite end of the crossarm from the wind sentry. The final sensor for this weather station is the RainView 20 tipping bucket rain gauge, a digital SDI-12 sensor to measure precipitation total and intensity. I'll use the CM241 rain gauge mount to attach the RainView to the top of a CM305 mounting pole installed at a clear distance from the main tripod. Use the mounting hardware to ensure the RainView is mounted perfectly level for proper function. All my sensors are now installed. Now it's time to wire everything to the data logger. I will follow the wiring diagram created by Shortcut to connect each sensor to the data logger. I will wire the sensors in the same order that I attach the sensors. First the BaroView, then the Wind Sentry. These are followed by the HygroView 10, the CS320, and then the RainView 20. Now it's time to tidy up the wiring. Start at each sensor and leave a drip loop below each sensor to prevent water from collecting on the sensor connection. Use zip ties to secure each wire in place. Route the wires down the mast and gather any extra wire into a loop below the enclosure. Zip tie the loop to hold it. Then zip tie the loop to the mast leg below the enclosure. Electrical conduit can be used to protect any cable buried or resting on the ground. This weather station is now ready to begin collecting data. Data can be collected manually by visiting the site or remotely using Campbell Scientific's flexible communication options, including Wi-Fi, Ethernet, cellular, and satellite communications. For more information on building a weather station or setting up remote communications, visit the Campbell Scientific website or contact one of our support engineers.